Well, Wendy, Pittsburgh police say the shootings overnight made 32 homicides in the city of Pittsburgh so far this year. There were 27 at this time last year. So they say they have increased patrols in the East End. And the chief says, although most of the victims recently were targets, anytime shots are fired, innocent people are in danger.
Littered with bullets and covered in crime scene tape, the corner of North St. Clair and Hayes is the spot of the city's latest murders, where teenagers lie victims of guns and violence.
I heard like 4 shots around 12 midnight.
Elise Moore was in her East Liberty home about a block away when the shooting started. She has heard it here before.
Well, maybe about once a week.
This time, police say 2 teenagers who had their faces covered and were carrying guns approached a car, exchanged shots with those inside, and were killed. The teens' murders have prompted messages on Facebook that show many here are becoming accustomed to violence. A friend of 17-year-old Daniel Hawkins writes, RIP, I'll look out for your family, I love ya. And DeAndre Dean's friends write, they're so tired of saying farewells through RIPs, but RIP DeAndre Dean, aka my partner in crime, died at 17 years old. The murders of Dean and Hawkins, along with other recent shootings in the city, have prompted Pittsburgh police to increase patrols in certain communities.
We will have basically our different units, impact unit, narcotics, our street response unit, as well as additional officers from other zone to patrol, to do saturation patrol in the Zone 5 area.
Likely a welcome sight for those such as Moore, who have seen violence in the past.
My husband got attacked one time.
And hear it on her street weekly.
Pittsburgh police are still investigating the shooting from East Liberty. At this point, they say they know the shots were fired from a dark-colored vehicle. They're not sure whether 1 or 2 people were inside that vehicle, but they do know the car hit a pole while leaving Hayes Street. If you have any information, you're asked to call Pittsburgh police. Reporting live, Marcy Cipriani, Channel 4 Action News.